A chemical shock for maximum city. Toxic fumes of chlorine leaked from cylinders dumped at the Bombay Port Trust. The poisonous gas soon spread, seriously affecting nearby residents. Nearly 80 people were hospitalized, students, cops and firefighters. There was a huge scare. Mumbai was lucky this time, but the danger still lurks.
The timing was eerie. Bhopal was gassed at midnight 26 years ago. And once again at midnight, Mumbai had a whiff of disaster. Noxious fumes of chlorine leaked from one of these rusted containers dumped at the Bombay Port Trust in savory suburb of Mumbai. It was 2:30 in the morning. Mixed with the air, the poisonous gas soon spread to neighboring areas including the Lal Bahadur Shastri College of Advanced Maritime Studies. Students woke up breathless. Choking, teary-eyed, they rushed out of the hostel, having the narrowest of narrow escapes.
People were banging on our doors, so we could evacuate the hostel immediately. So we were lucky to wake up and get away from there.
I was too much irritating and we can't breathe also.
3 o'clock from after that administration came, 5 o'clock. So 2 hours we were just staying outside this college.
Us time se bachcho ko kuch ko vomiting ho raha hai. Mujhe khud ko yahan par pura sore throat, chest pain. Breathing a problem, headache, nausea type of something.
By 3:30 a.m., the fire tenders were battling the leakage, trying to zero in on the damaged cylinder. For over 6 hours, they sprayed water on the cylinders, trying to dilute the gas.
615 kg capacity, that tunnel was leaking and out of that chlorine gas was coming out. And that has spread in the entire area. So initially going near to that cylinder was a problem. So my fireman officers, they wear the breathing apparatus set. They with the help of water curtain, we have restrained that leaking gas to come into the residential zone.
There was panic at the KEM and JJ hospitals as patients poured in, wheezing and coughing. 92 in all, including 14 students, 4 firefighters and a constable. They were all diagnosed with acute respiratory distress syndrome.
इनको सांस लेने के लिए तकलीफ हो रही थी और आंख में बर्निंग हो रहा था इन सब लोगों को रात में 4 बजे से लेकर एडमिट किया है.
But this was a disaster waiting to happen. For these cylinders, 136 in total, were lying here abandoned for the last 13 years. A hazardous scrap dumped right next door to a college.
Has been there for quite some time, which was to be auctioned off. And that is supposed to be an empty cylinder of chlorine. But sometimes you have residual chlorine which remains in the cylinder. And that leaked out.
That is chemical ka godown bahut purana hai. Ab ye kya hai, isko hatana padega. Agar yahan pe college hai, that is what we will have to do. Dekhna padega ki kya kara jaye ispe.
As usual, the government has woken up after the disaster. The shipping ministry has asked for a detailed report from the Bombay Port Trust. The chief minister too expressed concern, but it wasn't clear what action, if any, would be taken against callous officials.
We are equipped. They have in fact, in the Mumbai Municipal Corporation with all the disaster management team of the Government of India, they have attended to it and they have neutralized the entire thing. But it is a fact it was lying unattended. It shouldn't be there.
One would have thought a country which has braved the incidents like Bhopal gas tragedy would have learnt its lessons right. But sadly, that is just not the case. The sewage chlorine leakage is just a strong indication of how irresponsive the authorities are towards people. It was sheer luck of the people that the leakage was not immense. But the authorities still have a lot to answer to the people. With Kamalji Sandhu in Delhi, Aditya Man, Mangesh Amre and Pankaj Upadhyay in Mumbai for headlines today.